I still want another one with like a big bleach part.
Yeah, we could do a big old like whole hairline. I did that with someone who did the whole hairline in the back of black.
But I just want it like from like hair to hair.
Yeah, we don't have to OD. And so
like I had
you do
years
curls
ago.
And stuff.
Yeah, let me see if I still have that video. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that is pretty, yes.
There you go.
Oh, I did see that on your story. You look like a baby. Like, whose child
is
that? Whose child is that? Like, you look so young. I can't believe it. Even when you were posting your pictures with that.
Oh, I'm going to turn this off now. I knew it wasn't going to rain. It did not thunderstorm at all. And me and my friends did not get to go out. But I'm about to go to a bar real quick with one of my other friends. And I pin curled my hair. Let me show y'all what it's looking like when I take it down. Oh, I got on lashes in the style AO. Oh, let me show y'all what I look like when I stand up so y'all can see my outfit. I'm about to put on my white uptowns, but I got on my Skims. This is in the color Deep Sea. It's cute, right? It's cute, cute, cute. Anyway, Kara, what you were saying?
What are you doing?
I'm talking to my YouTube channel.
Hey, YouTubers.
That's not even how you say it.
Hi, YouTubers.
Subscribe to my YouTube page, Kara.
Subscribe to my bitch channel.
You really are
not. Fucking problem. Have you on a pretty...
All right, y'all. So I kind of I don't know what's going on my camera. Can you even see me? I'm sorry for the bad lighting. And but anyway, this is my outfit that I'm wearing out. It's Skims. It's in the color deep sea, and this is like the rib collection. So I'm just wearing this and a pair of white low top Uptowns, technically the Downtowns. Nobody says that. I don't even know why I'm saying that. These is Air Force Ones. We call them Ones in New York. I don't know. Throwaways in Harlem. But, yeah, this is what I'm wearing. Okay. Hopefully I have fun. Alright, I'll see y'all later. But, oh, y'all want to see my hair up close? Remember I was telling y'all how I was, like, running and my hair was still fine? Still freaking perfect. And my lashes are obviously from Taylor Minks, my brand. And this particular lashes are in the style AO. It has a really nice curl. Oh, love it. Lip gloss is Dior. Lip liner is Minks from Wet n Wild. And Chestnut from MAC Cosmetics. Yeah. Okay. See y'all tomorrow. I don't know what you want me to say, and I'm not here to be judged. I'm not. I don't drink. I'm not a drinker. Tonight I did the opposite of that, bitch. I had two pineapples with Malibu, and it was like in a tall glass, and then I had I had like two shots Casamigos. Oh, I think it was three shots Casamigos. Good night. Hey, you guys. So, I just came back from the mall. Me and Dominique, remember yesterday, I was telling y'all how we were supposed to go out or whatever. I feel like that's too much foundation. Ew. Not sure why it's coming up orange. But ew. Anyway, so Dominique and I, we were supposed to go out. We were supposed to go to the museum, to an art exhibit, whatever. And we were like watching the rain the entire time to see if it was gonna rain. And I just had a feeling that it wasn't, like, I don't know. I think it rained in other parts of New York, but it did not rain in Queens. And I'm pissed off about it because I wasted a whole day. And then honestly, it was kind of better because it's like, I didn't even know what I was going to wear yesterday anyway. And then today, I literally just got back 20 minutes ago. She's already dressed, which is annoying. She just moved to the Bronx, so she's coming to get me. Her and this other, one of her friends, he literally invited himself. I was like, fuck it. I'm just kind of like not in the mood today. Yeah, I'm just not in the mood today. Like, a lot happened yesterday. A lot transpired yesterday that was causing me to feel. I always feel. Causing me to go out drinking. Bitch, I don't want to drink. But, bitch, I was drinking last night, child. And, you know, a lot happened. So, I still kind of want to go out. Like, she's still like, yeah, we're not going to let this bring you down. Or whatever. She's like, oh, we're not gonna let this bring you down. Like, you know, we're gonna go out, we're gonna enjoy ourselves, we're gonna have fun. So I guess that's what we're gonna do. So I'm just doing my makeup. She's already dressed. Like, she's literally somebody who could get dressed 1, 2, 3 even with doing her makeup. Like, she doesn't do as much as I do. And like, I go into detail, obviously, with my makeup, with the contouring and the highlighting. But I went to the mall. I got up and I went to the mall. I was going to bring y'all with me, but I'm glad I didn't. Like, I was frustration. I was really frustrated in the mall. This weirdo was following me around the mall. And I went to Zara. And honestly, it's literally something about going to Queen Center Mall. Not Queen Center Mall. Something about going to Zara. Like, I don't know. Like, I think maybe because it's like the only Zara of, like, besides going to Manhattan. Like, besides going to the city, like, that's the only Zara. So it's forever crowded. I mean, upstairs, the line upstairs was wrapped around twice. Like, the whole upstairs. Like, you could barely shop. You could barely look for what you were, you could barely look, you could barely shop, you could barely pick up anything because, like, it was just people everywhere. And then those bitches refused to open their fucking fitting room. And it's like, yeah, I get the whole thing when COVID first started, but it's like, there's so many restrictions have been lifted and fitting rooms is open. Honestly, I just feel like they feel like it's better for them. Because, you know, like, fitting rooms, like, if you've ever worked in retail, I worked in retail when I, like, years ago, like, when I first, like, did the whole, you know, your first job thing, I worked in, like, Abercrombie & Fitch, and them fitting rooms at the end of the night, it was no joke, like, to be on fitting rooms, like, so basically, like, if you had somebody, like, on the morning shift, and they just didn't give a fuck about anything, and, like, you would come in, like, for the afternoon shift, that, sometimes, that fitting room would look like shit. That fitting room would look like freaking shit. And you don't even know where to start. Like, whenever I was on fitting rooms, like, I'll be putting shit away right away. Like, I'll be like, ma'am, you want that? Give it to me. Like, give it to me. That shit was going back right away because those piles in the fitting room at night was no joke. But anyway, yeah, so I guess it's probably easier for them to get in and get out with the fitting rooms closed. But it's so frustrating because I was really not trying to be that girl that was, like, trying to try on shit over their clothes. That is freaking tacky and ghetto. But at the end of the day, like, I live in Queens. Like, I cannot just, that's not like an accessible mall to me to go all the way out to Garden City. Like, it's not accessible to me. And so, you know, my sister, I know she likes to, like, now when she goes to the mall, she basically, like, will try on clothes in the bathroom, like, in the mall bathroom, and then take it back right there. But Zara, it was so disgusting. Like, the upstairs and the downstairs, like, it was literally, like, the lines were wrapped. And it's just, like, you people were sitting online for, like, at least 45 minutes to an hour. And it's just, like, dang, like, whatever. So then I went to a store that I really didn't want to go to. I was just trying to get something last minute. Honestly, I told myself I would stop shopping. So that's basically what I was doing. I would stop shopping. So normally I would always have something, like, just in case we were going out. But I told myself, like, I was really adamant on saving. And, you know, yeah, because I want to move next year, and I just want to, like, build my savings back up, and obviously, I just came back from vacation, but, I don't know, so right now, I'm just doing my makeup to meet up with her. I do not like being rushed, like, honestly, if she feel like she gonna rush me, like, I don't know, I'm just not having, like, the best. Honestly, I'm not gonna say that because I'm not gonna claim that. Like, you know, I'm pushing through, y'all. I'm pushing through the negativity that happened to me the day before. And I'm not gonna let it stop me or dampen my mood. Honestly, like, I ain't trying to give nobody an attitude because of what happened to me. Like, they didn't do anything to me. I don't like having misplaced anger. I don't like when people have misplaced anger towards me. So I'm really just gonna make the best of it. The most of it, and just call it a freaking day. Hopefully her friend is cool and chill, like, and she says, God willing, they are. Ooh, I got makeup all on my hairline, which I was not trying to do on my lace. I hate that. I really hate that for me. Yeah. All right, so I guess I'll just check back in with you guys when my makeup is done. Sidebar, I came back real quick because, like, I'm a true sci-fi fan. Like, I love anything. I think I told you guys that. Like, I love sci-fi. anything wizards, you know, flying shit. But I'm watching Sweet Tooth right now on Netflix. Like, what are you guys watching? Do you have any suggestions? Like, I really love it. I mean, it's definitely something you could watch with kids. It doesn't give me, like, overly kiddie vibes. Like, you know, like, oh, it's so childish. Like, it's really for kids. Like, it's definitely something that you could watch, like, yourself. Like, it definitely has a good plot and everything. But what are you guys watching? Do you have any sci-fi suggestions for me? Because one thing about me, I'm a binge watch the hell out of a show. I am going to binge watch it, and I'm going to finish it within 2 to 3 days. That's me. Like, I, whenever I'm doing my makeup, I'm definitely always listening to something. Like, not really music. I'm not really a music listener when I'm doing my makeup, but I'm definitely always listening to some type of movie. I just want to know if you guys have any suggestions, because I'm going to be done with this, like, pretty soon. I'm definitely going to be done with this show pretty damn soon. And I'm going to need something else. Mama got to keep going. Like, I prefer long series that I could just keep going and going and going and going. Because whenever I'm doing my makeup, I like to just, you know, listen. Whatever. So let me know, you guys. Let me know. Let me know. Let me know. So where'd I first spot? Do you want to be in the camera or not? I was going to turn it to you. This is Lorenzo. I just met him. So yo, far, so good. But this is Dominique's friend.
Lorenzo from Brownsville.
Period.
Yes.
And we outside.
Oh, we outside.
Let me show you how the bar. It's like lit. It's like lit.
I'm on this place with
this. Lorenzo actually found this place because basically the spot that I wanted to go to is not open till 5. It's about to be 5, but we had to, like, we had to get started. We had to pregame. Y'all, look at our drinks. What did you get, Lorenzo?
Red frozen sangria.
Okay, so I got a, what did I get? Blue Hawaiian, and she got a pina colada. As always, she really has to spice it up. Like, this is getting old, honestly. Don't play with me, Lorenzo. This shit is so fly. Sometimes I get the feeling. We not out here, we going upstairs.
Can't say gun for you niggas, Jeff Gordon. AP, it called me 50. AP, my the whole.